used to work at the 92nd Street Y, and then for personal reasons, I moved here in August. But I'm still working with their team there on a few things with Giving Tuesday, in particular Global Giving Tuesday, which is our community of leaders and organizations that are building unique Giving Tuesday movements in their countries, like Giving Tuesday UK. So, in America, we are celebrating our sixth Giving Tuesday this year. It was founded in 2012 by the 92nd Street Y, which is a community center in New York City. And the thinking behind it was, you know, in the States we have Thanksgiving, we have a huge Black Friday and Cyber Monday. I tried looking up the gift for Black Friday and it was terrifying. But all these days that are kicking off the holiday season are about consumption and eating as much as you can and getting the best deals. And we thought, how great would it be if we could harness that energy to get people to do good? And that's where Giving Tuesday started. Just last year in the US, we had hundreds of thousands of organizations participate and saw over $177 million raised online. That does not include the countless acts of kindness, the shirts and cans that were donated, the volunteer hours that were logged, and the many, many other ways people can give. That being said, we didn't start there. When Giving Tuesday was founded in 2012, we weren't sure how it was going to take and if it would catch on. And we were very excited to see activities in at least each of the 50 US states. But then in 2013, something interesting happened. We started seeing countries like Canada and Brazil and Israel and Australia come to us saying, like, you know, this Giving Tuesday thing, mind if we kind of take this concept and adapt it and customize it for our own country? And we started working with them on building these global movements, which they're really leading independently in their countries. In 2014, more countries, including the UK, came on board. In 2015, even more. Until last year, we had 20 global leaders around the world. Now, on top of all of this, we tracked Giving Tuesday activities, so people who are giving back, participating, talking about Giving Tuesday, in 98 countries. And what's really interesting about this is that they're doing it in countries where there's no Thanksgiving, and Black Friday and Cyber Monday maybe exist, but they're growing there. So the whole founding story that we have for Giving Tuesday isn't necessarily what's happening around the world, but the idea that there's a day where people can come together to give, that's working. Even just this year, we've already signed on some new countries. We have Armenia, Slovakia, Panama, Puerto Rico, Liberia, and many more lined up that will join in the coming months. So what's bringing this diverse group together? Like, what's making Giving Tuesday global? There are a few guiding principles and key themes that we're seeing around the world. The first is that it's creating a culture of giving. So no matter what country you're in, Giving Tuesday leaders are really boosting the culture of philanthropy, talking about giving back and getting people engaged. So if you are in the UK or the US, there's a strong tradition of giving to charity. Giving Tuesday is engaging people in new ways and using social media and new technologies to do so. In countries like Liberia, the sole purpose of Giving Tuesday is to talk about volunteerism and to get people to serve and to give their time. So Giving Tuesday is educating the public and taking on different shapes and forms throughout the world. These are just two examples. So this is a blanket that was woven by a student, a deafblind student in Tanzania. In Tanzania, the leaders worked with local government ministers and schools to raise awareness for education for children. And in particular, they wanted to highlight the special needs schools. So they had students create projects, which they sold as part of a fundraiser and a public event to raise awareness for those schools. In the Dominican Republic, one example is communities had a collection basket in the city center where people could donate to go towards a restoration project for another town that was destroyed in a storm in the north part of the island. So Giving Tuesday, again, there's no formula to it. It's all different all over the world. But people are learning about the many different ways that they can give. And through this, people are engaging local communities. So Giving Tuesday is a hashtag. People talk a lot online about it, but it's also a conversation that's bringing people together in person. In India Paridar AR, which is the movement in Argentina, they kicked off Giving Tuesday last year with a Zumba-thon, where 300 people came together to dance for good. Pretty cool. In Croatia, the leaders went around a small town outside of Zagreb and asked people, you know, what do you want to give to? How do you want to support? And can you share that with photos? So again, it's not just creating opportunities for people to give, but it's also creating opportunities for nonprofits, companies, schools, and organizations to talk to the public and to ask them what's meaningful to you and to invite them to participate. And that's building a whole layer of civic pride. In the U.S., we have over 85 cities, states, and towns that have formed their own Giving Tuesday movements. So there's like Al Give, which is Illinois, or Dallas Gives, or Brooklyn Gives, and they have their own websites, they have their own logos, usually a twist on the Giving Tuesday logo, their own hashtags, but they're building a campaign just for that local audience. We're seeing that happen all over the world. Canada had over 30 civic movements. In Brazil, Dia Sorocaba was a campaign to make Sorocaba the most generous city in the country. They had a competition against the other cities. And in Germany, they had a team of volunteers in five of the major cities go out and spread awareness for local organizations and for ways to give back. So it's creating this movement that's really engaging people at a local grassroots level. And that's inspiring everyday givers. One of the fun things about Giving Tuesday is you never know who's going to talk about it on the day. You can be a president, a big celebrity, a student, a teacher, a volunteer. Everyone is sharing the same story and just celebrating giving on the day. And that's happening mostly because a lot of partners and organizations are creating new and easy ways for people to give. From text to donate, to charity walks or runs, to new platforms for volunteering and social media awareness. People around the world are finding new ways to get involved, and it's creating this wider conversation around giving back and doing good. Because really, there's no barrier to participate in Giving Tuesday. We firmly believe and have been shown that everyone, even dogs and cats, have the capacity to get involved and to give. Because everyone can make a difference, and we've seen the data on this, we've seen the participation, and it's really tremendous how Giving Tuesday is helping communities around the world. So, behind all of this, there's this amazing, amazing group of global leaders, like Gap here, who are working every single day on a strategy, plans, outreach, toolkits, educational opportunities, events, for people to learn new strategies and ways to get involved and to participate in Giving Tuesday. There's lots of sharing and innovation happening at this level. It's a really close and amazing group. And there's also a lot of experimentation. In Singapore, Giving Tuesday is a week long, which I would go crazy if that was happening in the U.S., but it's Giving Week, and there's activities every day for people to do good. In the Spanish-speaking world, Giving Tuesday is known as Un Día para Dar. In Latin America, there's another campaign called Latinos Give, which is helping people learn more about crowdfunding. In Israel, they hosted Giving Tuesday on a day that was like 3 weeks after Giving Tuesday. It wasn't even on the same day. And it still worked. It was the biggest day of giving in their country. So whatever it is, the leaders are looking at that culture, and they're adapting Giving Tuesday, they're owning it, and they're making it resonate with that audience. And this creativity, this collaboration, and innovation is really what's driving Giving Tuesday all over the world. And it's letting people and organizations decide, you know, what giving means to them, and therefore what Giving Tuesday means in their country. It's showing that anyone can be a leader of the movement. Some of the best campaigns come from the smallest organizations. And it also is interesting to prove, not to get political because I am the only American speaker, that you know, Giving Tuesday is a day that's not about consumption or shopping, it's a day about giving. And that's what's uniting people across religions, political boundaries, and cultures. And it's really becoming a day where the world's coming together just to do one thing, and that's to give.